Hey everyone, it's Pete here, and this is Pete as well. It's Pete and Repeat, I guess, Greenhouse on the River. Listen, I guess it's kind of a bittersweet time for you guys here. You've been here a long time, Peter.
Yeah, we built the place and 34 years, poured the concrete, built the buildings, and changed the business for a lot of years, which all businesses do. Yeah, so it's time for change.
Yeah.
New life, new blood, new vision. New energy.
When you're in this kind of business, especially, I guess it doesn't matter what community, but in a community like this, you're dedicated and you're there every day, whether you feel like it or not. That's a lot of summers to be tied up. So you're looking forward to a little bit of a break coming up.
Well, you know, it's a reality for a lot of people who run small businesses who are open, you know, six, seven days a week. And yeah, there's no sick days. And you know, when it's living plants, you have a saying, it's like cows in the barn. Once the cows are in the barn, you got to be there every day. So we grow last few years, probably 50,000 pots, 80,000 plants in total. So every single one's got to be taken care of every day.
That's a lot of plants, a lot of flowers over the years. Yeah. And I know you have dozens, if not hundreds, of great memories from this place. Is there a couple that sort of stick out? Was it coming off a storm or something, or you know, anything that really stands out to you over the years?
Well, I think when we started, we were a wholesale.
Okay.
And almost everything we grew went to Farm Boy, to the Strano family,
right.
John and now Dale Strano at Farm Boy on Lansdowne. And
so that's where all my good stuff is.
So there was kind of mutual growing pains, I call it, and we kind of helped each other grow our business through the years. So those kind of memories that, you know, we were just talking to both of them in the last week, which was kind of fun.
Yeah.
And I would say in the last week, a lot of people just coming in, thanking us and wishing us well. So ultimately, it's not how many plants I grew, or it's more, you know, the relationships we've made. Yeah.
Speaking of people, how important was it to you, and how good do you feel about the fact that this is sort of kind of staying local?
We never put it out listing wise. We had a couple of interested local people. We were, I think, fortunate to have that. Yeah, I mean, she's in the community and has a passion for plants, which is the key. some people just can't help themselves. I know I can't help myself with certain things.
Yeah.
I call myself the coleus king of Eastern Ontario, and
right.
I got a little carried away, you know. I got 65 varieties of coleus we had this year, just as an example. You got to have a passion for it.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, so all the very best. You're just going to be down in Lakefield, so you're not going far, so we'll be seeing you, and congratulations once again.
Thank you, Peter. I appreciate it.
All right, so here we are with the new owner here, and it's Robin Jenkins. Robin, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Are you excited?
I am.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How did this all come about for you? Like, how did you decide, you know what, I'm gonna get into the greenhouse business?
Well, I just love business in general, and I own Lakefield Flowers and Gifts. And last year we decided to expand, and I bought a house in Lakefield that's known as the Stone House, and we were going to expand there and do a garden center, but unfortunately, because of township rules, we couldn't actually pursue that dream. So we parked that, we restored it back to the house. It's now an Airbnb, sleeps 11 people, it's gorgeous. So then this November, Ellen called me and she let me know that Ellen Green, the owner, the current owner now, let me know that they have decided to sell and they thought that I would be a great fit for taking over. And at first I said, I don't know, I don't think so.
Yeah.
And I thought about it for a week and then I called her back and I said, you know what, I think it is a good fit.
Yeah.
And so we've just been going through the motions and so far so good.
Yeah, well, congrats. That's a great story, and the fact that it's kind of staying local as well, I think I think it means something to them. And obviously, you know, you've known about this place, you've grown up in this area.
Yeah, so I'm from Lakefield. I went to Ridpath School actually with Peter and Ellen's kids.
Yeah.
And it's great that it has come kind of full circle with not being able to do the first project, and everybody was so involved and supportive with that venture, and to see it not come to fruition was disappointing for me and a lot of people in the community. So I think people are very excited that we actually get to live out this dream.
And it's really, I mean, you got the river right across the way. It's a gorgeous setting. Knowing you a little bit, I imagine, you know, the brain is ticking here and you got ideas that I'm sure you don't want to get into a whole bunch, but I could see some things happening here on the property.
Yeah. So we want to expand and do some landscaping, which we've already kind of started doing. We are doing landscaping jobs now. So it's not something that they ever dived into, but because they were only open 2 months of the year, and you know what, that was perfect for them, but we're going to expand the season to 10 months of the year, do Christmas events and all that, and do the landscaping. So yeah, we're really excited.
Awesome. Okay, before we let you go, you're from Lakefield, you went to RidPath, so you're sort of born and raised. What's the best thing about Lakefield?
I think the best thing about Lakefield is that everybody is so creative. There's so many artists in this community. Mm-hmm. It's such a beautiful town. It's a supportive town. Everybody's so positive and loving, and you know, I'm really proud to be from such a great little town.
Right on. Well, again, congrats. You're going to do great, and we'll see you here on, and you're kind of renaming it, right? Is that right?
Yes, we are. We are renaming the greenhouse, so Charlie's Riverside Gardens, and Charlie is actually spelt my middle name, C-H-A-R-L-E-A.
There you have it. And there's a meaning behind that, or is it?
So Charlie's just my middle name, and it's my dad's name as well. That's right.
There you go. All right, a family, family touch for sure. All right, thanks for watching, everyone. Hometown PTVO.
Thanks for joining us on this edition of Hometown PTBO, brought to you by Darling Insurance.